Hello, welcome back to Project Kermit. So here we are extracting the chassis from the workshop. And the last time you saw the chassis, I just spent months welding up all the holes in it. But before it can go for galvanizing, we have to put a load of new holes in it. These new holes that we're working out where to drill are essential for the galvanizing process because it's going to be dipped in a bath of molten zinc. And these holes will allow the hot gases that are inside the box sections to escape. They'll allow the zinc to get in and then the excess zinc to drain out again. You've put the chassis on the dumper to get access all the way around it, and next to the dumper you can see another chassis. Now this one's not mine, but I've just borrowed it to use as a reference. Despite its manky looks, this is actually a replica chassis that's already been galvanized, so it already has all those drain holes in exactly the right places. So what we're doing here is measuring one chassis and then mapping those holes onto my chassis. Once mapped out, it's just a case of pilot drilling the holes and then enlarging them with a step drill, and they're all 10mm, 12mm holes. Whatever was on the other chassis we copied over. I'm not sure how many holes we ended up with in total, but it took all day. So the chassis is finally ready, but it's not the only thing that I want to get galvanized. There's also a bulkhead, windscreen surround, and a few other bits and bobs.
Ready?
Yeah.
Contact.
Okay.
Well, look what I brought home. Kermit chassis, bulkhead and everything else, all lovely and shiny. Very shiny. I've taken the straps off, but I haven't had a close look yet. I went to a company called Newport Galvanising over the bridge in Wales, and I have to say they did a really nice job with this from what I've seen so far. And I didn't tell them beforehand that it was going to be on YouTube or anything like that. I didn't get any special treatment. In fact, I don't think they'd have cared anyway. They didn't really want to do the job. It's a proper industrial plant. This is very much small potatoes to them. I have my ticket here, and I can tell you that no special treatment, no discounts, none of that. It came to £639.29. Which, that sounds quite steep. I think it's gone up a lot recently. I did get a couple of other quotes and they were all about the same. So I wasn't being ripped off or anything. It's just prices of everything had gone up, I think. Something I expected to happen, and sure enough it did, is this. So you might remember when I rebuilt the chassis and I repaired all these sections, everything was ground flush. I spent ages grinding everything completely flush, and yet when the zincs got on, the seams are now proud, they all jump out again. And this strange phenomena of the seams popping out where they were previously sanded flush, I have heard or read somewhere back in the midst of time that it's something to do with the traces of silicon that are in the MIG welding wire. I don't know if that's true, but I have noticed on places like this where I arc welded it, it's a different welding process using the electrodes, those seams don't pop out, so maybe there is something in that. Oh, I'll tell you something I want to check, the chassis number. So you might recall a long time ago when I rebuilt the dumb irons, I managed to keep most of the original material, including the bit that had the chassis number on. Not on that one. Oh, yes. And there it still is. So for the most part, it's come out immaculate. There's the odd, slightly gacky bit, like here, and around here where the shock absorber goes onto, where it just wasn't perfectly prepared. But I'm actually happy to claim that the odd gacky bit here and there really just proves that for the most part, my preparation before it went to galvanizing was pretty much cock on. So two of the things that really made this work, and bear in mind this is a 40-year-old chassis that's been dipped. One was the fact that I took the time to blast the inside as well as the outside, and I really got rid of every trace of underseal paint and whatnot that was on there. There was some flash rusting when it went, but because they dip it in acid before dipping it in the zinc, that's not an issue. It's much more of an issue if you've got grease and paint and things like that, and like I say, that was pretty much all gone. The other thing that I did was to copy a brand new chassis in where I drilled all the vent holes. So that meant, one, I saved money because if you don't do it, they'll drill the holes for you and charge you. But for two, it meant I had all the holes in the right places and it just made their life easier, but also it meant that this went in and out in the proper fashion. Hopefully there's not too much glare going on at the moment. You should be able to see that this is what most of the areas look like. So this was a brand new replacement, this outrigger here, and of course this is all the original material, and it all looks absolutely perfect. Obviously the chassis is upside down, I haven't had a chance to look at the top side yet, but I'm sure it's just as good. Bear in mind these are dipped on their side. You might be able to make out there, there's some excess zinc in that corner, so that indicates that this would have been the very top of the frame, so they would have hung it from this end, or this side of the chassis, and dipped it in. And while I was at it, I got my bike rack done as well, which has made quite a dramatic difference. Let's see. Yes, that's going to smarten that right up. I can put some panniers on now. So all in all, I'm really happy with the way it came out, and I think for me, for this project, it was definitely the way to go. It was a good decision to do it. and I'm happy to recommend Newport Galvanizing if you can stomach the price, and which, to be fair, I don't think is their fault. I think that's a global issue. Cost of zinc, gas, and so on and so forth. Well, having admired the results, the one burning question is it still straight and square? Or has the dip in it in that molten zinc twisted it in some way? Well, let's find out. If you're wondering why I've got two windscreen surrounds, I'm kind of wondering that too, but happy to have a spare again. I also got this done, of course. This is the gearbox cross member, which will bolt in there. And I got these done. These are the bulkhead to chassis brackets. Now what we need is a controlled descent. That's interesting. This engine mount I didn't take off until after the blasting, and you can see how just that little bit of grease on it has completely stopped the zinc adhering. Not really, not a problem there, obviously. That's the engine bay, it's going to be full of oil. Everywhere else looks absolutely lovely. Just like before then, I'm going to chock up the chassis and I'm going to make the front end level, and then we'll see how far out the back end is relative to the front. Then I'll measure some diagonals and we'll see how off square it is. Up in the air now, both ends. Straight. I've got some old chisels which should work well as shims, so I'm just gonna lift up one side until we get the bubble in the middle. I've got a chisel shape as a wedge. Okay, so we're level on there. Now, as I recall, previously, the best I got it after all the work that I did on this was when it was level at the front, it was 2 mil out on the top here, at the back, and pretty much level at the bottom of this cross member. It's a little bit uneven now here, but if anything, it's got better. Check that out. Well, that's quite amazing. It seems to now be more level, less twisted than it was when it went off, and it was within 2 millimeters then, so that couldn't be much better, really. What I want to do now is try and measure some diagonals. I think I went from there. 3, 4, 9, 6. And we are 3, 4, 9. 3, 4, 9, 2. That's great, that's a 4mm difference, which I think, from memory, I haven't actually gone back and reviewed the video, but I think that's exactly what it was. And I didn't expect that one to change, really, because of the amount of structure that's in this going this way. But I was slightly concerned that there was a possibility of putting the twist back in that I took out. Simply because when I took out the twist, I put the chassis under enormous strain to force it beyond its elastic limit to where I wanted it to be. That puts a lot of stress in the whole structure, and there was a chance that that stress would be relieved by dipping it in molten zinc. Fortunately, that hasn't happened. Or if it has happened, it's happened to my benefit very slightly, which is excellent. So anyway, all in all, that's terrific news. Whew. Now it's just a case of putting it all back together.